Miracle is not a new technology. Miracle is a transformation of surgery.
In the Miracle Project, it's all about cutting bones. But in contrast to the state of the art, we are not cutting bones with chisels and saws and hammers and drills, but we are actually cutting them with laser light.
Miracle, basically, as the name says, is about a minimal invasive robot-assisted computer-guided laser osteotome. It's a small endoscopic device that is guided by a robot, where planning has been done previously from patient-specific data, and then the robot guides a laser towards a surgical site and cuts the bone.
We know that laser actually can do bone surgery very well, but the problem with laser surgery is because it can cut everything. Even if you move like a couple of micron or a couple of millimeter, it can already damage the surrounding. So that's why precise cutting using a robot is very important.
The old way of doing surgery, especially in bone surgery, is or was to do it with traditional tools like this saw. This is a saw we used in the last century. Huh? It's still the same procedure. I cut and I cut a straight line from A to B. And now take the laser. With the laser, you can do free geometry. So instead of a straight line, if I know there is a nerve or some other sensitive structures, I do a slight movement around. Laser physics changed so that we could do these cuts in cold ablation. If you look into the cellular structure of the bone, you have the impression the bone didn't even realize that it was touched.
The laser light is only absorbed by the water and not by the bone itself. And then water expands due to vaporization and then chips away the bones. And this is flying out of the cut with a speed of Mach 2. And the remaining tissue stays cool. We never observe temperatures higher than 45, 50 degrees centigrade. This is why the bone and the natural material is still intact. If you compare this to a saw, there we observed temperatures of the cooling water in the range of 80 to 100 degrees centigrade.
So BLOX stands for a biomedical laser and optics group. So basically the group is basically focusing on any type of application of optics and laser in biomedical. The laser can be considered as a dumb system. Why I said dumb system? Because basically they don't know exactly how far they cut and they don't know exactly what type of tissue they are cutting. So that's the drawback of using lasers. So that's why we need some kind of optical feedback or any type of feedback that actually can show the surgeon that they are cutting a very important tissue. What surgeons like to have is basically imaging. So we also use what we call optical coherence tomography, or OCT, which is basically an imaging system that actually can give you 3D information of the cutting process. The advantages with OCT is basically it's an imaging system. So you basically get the whole information about the process of the laser cutting. So you will have, for example, the image of the first layer and then the layer where you're going to cut, for example, how far you cut and so on. And then in this end of the cut, you actually can have some information as well as an image of the tissue that will be cut next.
Biomed Lab is an acronym for Bio-Inspired Robots for Medicine Lab, and we create everything that is needed to get the robot working. So we try to find out which components we need on the mechanical side, but also on the electronic side, and then we really start designing the electric cabinets, even electronics, start designing mechanics. We assemble then everything, so we don't build everything in-house. Some parts we do, some parts we manufacture externally. But we assemble everything here, get it working, get the controllers set up and working, and also use interfaces. So basically, in the end, from an idea, we create the first working prototype. What now is the very big challenge for us in this Miracle project is that all the technologies need to go between those four small rods that you see. Between those four rods, we will have a camera, suction, irrigation, we'll have a laser that cuts, we'll have a laser that measures, and maybe other components still. So the challenge is not to have a big complex device, but we have a small complex device.
We have to tell the robot exactly what to cut, and for this we need very accurate planning, where the surgeon preoperatively defines the locations and the specific shapes of the cuts that the robot should perform. Planning these surgical interventions was a very tedious task because they had to manually segment the bones in the CT data sets. In some cases, they were segmenting the same patient seven times in different software platforms because they were not compatible. And this is where we came up with using virtual reality to do this. They started to like our virtual reality solution that we developed for the laser cutting. But surgeons were so keen on using our virtual reality solution that we already implemented it in the clinics in daily routine for aneurysma cases. Whenever we have visitors, we often show them a patient from Basel that had an aneurysm. And normally I only show them the big aneurysm in this patient that burst, but this patient also has a smaller aneurysm on the contralateral, so on the other side. And even layperson, they immediately recognize that this patient also has a second aneurysm, and they often tell me, but this patient has a second aneurysm. And this only tells me how intuitive these virtual reality solutions are, that even a patient or a lay person dares to make this diagnosis in principle.
Why do we need smart implants? And what is the relation between smart implants and the laser osteotome? The laser is a tool, and the tool gives us a possibility to do completely new cuts in the body of a person. Instead of a big implant, I can use an implant in different or several parts. So instead of one, I have one, two, three, four pieces. Why should I make four pieces and not only a one-piece implant? Because Miracle offers me the opportunity to do it minimally invasive. So if I have an implant which needs a big opening, a big cut in the soft tissue to bring it into the body, I can do open surgery. It's already everything open. But if I have a small keyhole where I put the Miracle device through, I use the same small keyhole to put the first part of the implant, I fix it, and then I put the second. And so I bring it in the body. I stick it together like a Lego system. We have patented it.
Minimally invasive laser bone surgery, as we have shown it in this video, promises many advantages. The wounds of the patients can be a lot smaller. The bone remains more intact and can therefore heal faster. The interventions are also more precise due to the robot guidance. And lastly, the technology also allows the use of multi-part implants. In the end, it is always about the well-being of the patient. When we began to understand the potential of how much robot-guided laser surgery could help patients, we simply had to try to make it happen.